Very good morning to you. Welcome to Proactive London. Dr Markku Jalkanen, CEO of Faron Pharmaceuticals, joins us. Hot off the presses, your half-year financial results. It's good to see you this morning. These results only out in the past few hours. I know you've said in the release you're very proud of the progress you've made in the first half. So good morning to you. And by all means, give us some of the highlights.
Yeah, thank you. Good morning. Yeah, it's amazing. We are kind of a living strange times, but still we are progressing. And I'm really proud of all the clinics who are really exploring the use of bexmarilimab in those cancer patients. And all the data we are collecting is pointing pretty much to the same direction. We can really activate the immune system in those patients. And this is extremely important if you want to have a maximal benefit from the current immuno-oncology products like PD-1 blockade. So it really looks to us that the Bex is really bringing up a new step in the cancer treatment. And obviously, we are really trying to accelerate the programs as fast as we can. We pretty much financially did what we expected, 12 million investments in that program, mainly in that program. And the results are something that we really would like to next take to the regulators, mainly FDA, in order to really understand what's the way forward. And while doing that, we already have started two additional trials. The first, hematological malignancy, is ongoing. We have first patients recruited in that one, and that is really exciting. Another trial setting where we are now really looking a cancer type where we have a very, very limited possibilities to help the patients. Then the whole world of the combo treatments with the PD-1 blockade, that's on the way. And again, this is really exciting time for us. Absolutely.
As you say, yes, we're coming out of strange times with the pandemic, but of course, the cancer treatment and the treatment and who knows, hopefully one day the cure of cancer continues apace. It's one of the most evil diseases known. And of course, we wish you the best of luck. You said there's some very impressive data and some results coming out. Can you let us know which of those results most impressed you regarding the use of the bexmarilimab?
First of all, it has been really well tolerated, and it's unusual for a new cancer drug behaving like that. We believe it's due to the fact that the same kind of a regulatory pathway is also in use of the physiological settings, and the pregnancy is one of the examples where the same type of the cells are used to immune suppress locally to protect the embryo, growing embryo. Then the second is that we have a biomarker set up now really to identify the patients who actually can benefit from treatment as a single agent. And obviously, that is really important when you go to talk to the regulators, if you can identify the patient, because often it feels that we are using whatever is available for the patients and not really know the outcome. And that is something that is driving us really to move forward. And then the last one, which is really important one, this is a new mode of action, which is not in use yet. And we need to get it into the market as fast as possible, really to help those people. You know, you get hearing almost on a weekly basis, some of your friends are suffering from cancer, and it's really dramatic change for the people who are really getting it. And I definitely would be extremely proud one day when the Bex is really in use in those patients.
Absolutely. It's one of those areas of research, medical research, whereby it's not just something that happens to other people at one time in our lives. All of us, or indeed our close relatives and friends, are bound to be touched by this terrible disease. Is it normal to get such potent signs of efficacy so early in the R&D process as regards to this type of treatment?
Not very often. And especially when you are dealing with the new mode of action, it's really interesting that you get to see this early. And this could mean that with the single randomized trial, we may move on with forward even to talk about the conditional approval. But we are more interested really testing that now in this combination, because if that is in the first line treatment already very effective, then we don't really need to wait to the last line what we are dealing with at the moment. So all the plans is really now coming through. And I'm also really proud of our new CMO who joined us in January, has really had a tremendous impact on our product pipeline development plans. And we are just now executing those.
That sounds very encouraging indeed. What should we expect in the next, say, year to year and a half regarding any clinical or data points regarding your research?
Well, the main trial, it has been Matins. Those conclusions we hope to be able to get out during Q3, Q4. Then the bexmarilimab, that's the hematological malignancy, that is an open trial, and those patients are monitored very carefully. So we hope to get the first cohort done soon and then move on to the next one. And in between of those, obviously, there could be a possibility to report how that is progressing. And I'm happy to say that we were able to start that trial with rather high dosing order. So it's 1 mg/kg every week, which should have an impact. So we are really kind of thrilled on that part as well.
Absolutely. And just briefly, before we part company, are you talking to any potential partners at all? And if so, do you have any kind of interest from people that you're speaking to regarding that instance?
That's an ongoing process. And more data we collect, more interested it is. And as I have said earlier, we want to produce some additional data in order to really optimize the value within those talks, because that is also the interest of the shareholders. Not to do it too early, but do at the right time. There could be possibilities to do some limited territorial deals, but obviously we are really looking for a partner also who could actually really take the product all the way to the global markets.
Absolutely. Imperative in this kind of research.
Absolutely.
And this kind
yep.
of marketing. Thank you very much. It's all very encouraging. Of course, we appreciate your time and hope you'll keep us updated soon. That's Dr. Markku Jalkanen, CEO of Faron Pharmaceuticals on Proactive London.
Thank you very much.